single day.
Laws involving protests and counter-protests, the Ten Commandments of Protesting. Recently, we were asked by some protesters who felt they were intimidated, assaulted, suppressed, defamed or battered about what they could do. If someone has violated these Ten Commandments, you can file charges. Others have asked for some ground rules to keep in mind before a protest. By contrast, if you are doing any of these actions, you may be violating Florida law. Your rights begin where another person's ends. Certainly, we are all aware that there are not and can be no law abridging the freedom of speech, or of the press, or the right of the people peaceably to assemble, and to petition the government for a redress of grievances. However, within that Florida has laws which basically define what peaceable assembly is. I thou shalt not touch or hit another. Two basic laws apply here, 1, battery and, 2, affray, fighting. You cannot commit an unwanted touching to a person and you cannot fight. Battery. 784.03 Battery, Felony Battery. 1. A. The offense of battery occurs when a person 1. Actually and intentionally touches or strikes another person against the will of the other, or 2. Intentionally causes bodily harm to another person. B. Except as provided in subsection 2, a person who commits battery commits a misdemeanor of the first degree, punishable as provided in S-775.082 or S-775.083. 2. A person who has one prior conviction for battery, aggravated battery, or felony battery and who commits any second or subsequent battery commits a felony of the third degree, punishable as provided in S-775.082, S-775.083, or S-775.084. For purposes of this subsection, conviction means a determination of guilt that is the result of a plea or a trial, regardless of whether adjudication is withheld or a plea of nolo contendere is entered. And affray. 870.01 Affrays and Riots. 1. All persons guilty of an affray shall be guilty of a misdemeanor of the first degree, punishable as provided in S-775.082 or S-775.083. 2. Thou shalt not threaten or intimidate another. Two more basic laws apply here, 1. Threats and, 2. Assault. You cannot use words or actions to harm another with malice or which causes well-founded fear. Threats or extortion. 836.05 Threats. Extortion whoever, either verbally or by written or printed communication, maliciously threatens to accuse another of any crime or offense, or by such communication maliciously threatens an injury to the person, property, or reputation of another, or maliciously threatens to expose another to disgrace, or to expose any secret affecting another, or to impute any deformity or lack of chastity to another, with intent thereby to extort money or any pecuniary advantage whatsoever. Or with intent to compel the person so threatened, or any other person, to do any act or refrain from doing any act against his or her will, shall be guilty of a felony of the second degree, punishable as provided in S-775.082, S-775.083, or S-775.084. And Assault. 784.011 Assault. 1. An assault is an intentional, unlawful threat by word or act to do violence to the person of another, coupled with an apparent ability to do so, and doing some act which creates a well-founded fear in such other person that such violence is imminent. 2. Whoever commits an assault shall be guilty of a misdemeanor of the second degree, punishable as provided in S-775.082 or S-775.083. 3. Thou shalt not stalk or harass another. This concept is about the harassment or stalking of another. It's broad, but should be kept in your arsenal of things to avoid. Stalking. 784.048 Stalking, Definitions, Penalties. 1. As used in this section, the term A. harass means to engage in a course of conduct directed at a specific person which causes substantial emotional distress to that person and serves no legitimate purpose. B. Course of conduct means a pattern of conduct composed of a series of acts over a period of time, however short, which evidences a continuity of purpose. The term does not include constitutionally protected activity such as picketing or other organized protests. C. Credible threat means a verbal or nonverbal threat, or a combination of the two, including threats delivered by electronic communication or implied by a pattern of conduct, which places the person who is the target of the threat in reasonable fear for his or her safety or the safety of his or her family members or individuals closely associated with the person, and which is made with the apparent ability to carry out the threat to cause such harm. It is not necessary to prove that the person making the threat had the intent to actually carry out the threat. The present incarceration of the person making the threat is not a bar to prosecution under this section. D. Cyberstalk means to engage in a course of conduct to communicate, or to cause to be communicated, words, images, or language by or through the use of electronic mail or electronic communication, directed at a specific person, causing substantial emotional distress to that person and serving no legitimate purpose. 2. A person who willfully, maliciously, and repeatedly follows, harasses, or cyberstalks another person commits the offense of stalking, a misdemeanor of the first degree, punishable as provided in S. 775.082 or S. 775.083. 3. A person who willfully, maliciously, and repeatedly follows, harasses, or cyberstalks another person and makes a credible threat to that person commits the offense of aggravated stalking, a felony of the third degree, punishable as provided in S. 775.082. S. 775.083, or S. 775.084. 6. A law enforcement officer may arrest, without a warrant, any person that he or she has probable cause to believe has violated this section. 4. Thou shalt not wear a disguise. We have seen many people wear various head coverings and masks during protests. Do so at your own peril. Disguise as obstruction. 843.03 Obstruction by disguised person whoever in any manner disguises himself or herself with intent to obstruct the due execution of the law, or with the intent to intimidate, hinder, or interrupt any officer, beverage enforcement agent, or other person in the legal performance of his or her duty or the exercise of his or her rights under the Constitution or laws of the state, whether such intent is affected or not, shall be guilty of a misdemeanor of the first degree, punishable as provided in S. 775.082 or S. 775.083. Disguise on public property. 876.13 Wearing mask, hood, or other device on public property. No person or persons shall in this state, while wearing any mask, hood, or device whereby any portion of the face is so hidden, concealed, or covered as to conceal the identity of the wearer, enter upon, or be, or appear upon or within the public property of any municipality or county of the state. Disguise on public way. 876.12 Wearing mask, hood, or other device on public way. No person or persons over 16 years of age shall, while wearing any mask, hood, or device whereby any portion of the face is so hidden, concealed, or covered as to conceal the identity of the wearer, enter upon, or be or appear upon any lane, walk, alley, street, road, highway, or other public way in this state. Disguise while displaying an exhibit. 876.20 Wearing mask and placing exhibit to intimidate it shall be unlawful for any person or persons while wearing a mask or any device whereby the face is so covered as to conceal the identity of the wearer to place, or to cause to be placed, at, on, or in any place any exhibit of any kind whatsoever. V. Thou shalt not publicly display an exhibit which intends to intimidate. Some of these are very vague and subjective, but for the record you cannot have posters or other exhibits which have an intention of intimidating. Intimidating exhibit. 876.19 Exhibits that intimidate it shall be unlawful for any person or persons to place, or cause to be placed, anywhere in the state any exhibit of any kind whatsoever with the intention of intimidating any person or persons, to prevent them from doing any act which is lawful, or to cause them to do any act which is unlawful. 6. Thou shalt not defame. Although rarely enforced and even extremely outdated by equal protection standards, there is a Florida law which prohibits criminal defamation. Criminal defamation. 836.04 Defamation. Whoever speaks of and concerning any woman, married or unmarried, falsely and maliciously imputing to her a want of chastity, shall be guilty of a misdemeanor of the first degree, punishable as provided in S. 775.082 or S. 775.083. 7. Thou shalt not disturb another's assembly. This comes in two forms: a specific right to not have a lawful assembly disrupted and a law prohibiting breach of the peace. Willful interruption of assembly. 871.01 Disturbing schools and religious and other assemblies. 1. Whoever willfully interrupts or disturbs any school or any assembly of people met for the worship of God or for any lawful purpose commits a misdemeanor of the second degree, punishable as provided in S. 775.082 or S. 775.083. Breach of the peace. 877.03 Breach of the peace, disorderly conduct. Whoever commits such acts as are of a nature to corrupt the public morals, or outrage the sense of public decency, or affect the peace and quiet of persons who may witness them, or engages in brawling or fighting, or engages in such conduct as to constitute a breach of the peace or disorderly conduct, shall be guilty of a misdemeanor of the second degree, punishable as provided in S. 775.082 or S. 775.083. 8. Thou shalt not damage property. Criminal mischief is another commonly cited by police, as a catch-all, particularly with incidents of property damage or vandalism. Criminal mischief. 806.13 Criminal mischief, penalties, penalty for minor. 1. A. A person commits the offense of criminal mischief if he or she willfully and maliciously injures or damages by any means any real or personal property belonging to another, including, but not limited to, the placement of graffiti thereon or other acts of vandalism thereto. B. 1. If the damage to such property is $200 or less, it is a misdemeanor of the second degree, punishable as provided in S. 775.082 or S. 775.083. 2. If the damage to such property is greater than $200 but less than $1,000, it is a misdemeanor of the first degree, punishable as provided in S. 775.082 or S. 775.083. 3. If the damage is $1,000 or greater, or if there is interruption or impairment of a business operation or public communication, transportation, supply of water, gas, or power, or other public service which costs $1,000 or more in labor and supplies to restore, it is a felony of the third degree, punishable as provided in S. 775.082, S. 775.083, or S. 775.084. 9. Thou shalt not incite a riot. This is a new one for us. However, recently protesters were charged under the incitement or encouraging a riot language. It appeared that the counter-protesters were the one who incited any fighting or disorder, but here is what the law says. Inciting a riot. 870.01 A phrase and riots. 2. All persons guilty of a riot, or of inciting or encouraging a riot, shall be guilty of a felony of the third degree, punishable as provided in S. 775.082, S. 775.083, or S. 775.084. X. Thou shalt not resist a lawful arrest. In almost every circumstance, we would recommend peacefully obeying the orders of law enforcement. However, Sometimes this is a little more complex, but also very subjective. As you can see, there is a requirement that a law enforcement officer be acting in good faith at the time of the arrest. To further that point, Jackson v. State, 463 SO.2D 372, FLA 5th DCA 1985, clearly states, while an arrest, whether lawful or unlawful, may never be resisted with violence, any excessive force accompanying such arrest may be forcefully defended against. ID, citing S 776.012, FLA STAT. Outside cases of excessive force, the law is very clear that one may not resist even an illegal arrest with violence. See Jones v. State, App 5 DIST, 570 SO.2D 433, 1990, stating a person is not justified in using force to resist arrest where it is reasonably believed that person making arrest is law enforcement officer, even if arrest is technically illegal, and Nesmith v. State, App 2 DIST, 616 SO.2D 170, 1993, use of force in resisting arrest by a person reasonably known to be law enforcement officer is unlawful notwithstanding technical illegality of arrest. Resisting arrest with violence. 843.01 Resisting officer with violence to his or her person whoever knowingly and willfully resists, obstructs, or opposes any officer as defined in S 943.10, 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, or 9, member of the Florida Commission on Offender Review or any administrative aide or supervisor employed by the Commission, parole and probation supervisor, county probation officer, personnel or representative of the Department of Law Enforcement, or other person legally authorized to execute process in the execution of legal process or in the lawful execution of any legal duty, by offering or doing violence to the person of such officer or legally authorized person, is guilty of a felony of the third degree, punishable as provided in S 775.082, S 775.083, or S 775.084. Resisting arrest without violence. 843.02 Resisting officer without violence to his or her person whoever shall resist, obstruct, or oppose any officer as defined in S 943.10, 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, or 9, member of the Florida Commission on Offender Review or any administrative aide or supervisor employed by the Commission, county probation officer, parole and probation supervisor, personnel or representative of the Department of Law Enforcement, or other person legally authorized to execute process in the execution of legal process or in the lawful execution of any legal duty, without offering or doing violence to the person of the officer, shall be guilty of a misdemeanor of the first degree, punishable as provided in S 775.082 or S 775.083. Defense to resisting arrest. 776.051 Use or threatened use of force in resisting arrest or making an arrest or in the execution of a legal duty, prohibition. 1. A person is not justified in the use or threatened use of force to resist an arrest by a law enforcement officer, or to resist a law enforcement officer who is engaged in the execution of a legal duty, if the law enforcement officer was acting in good faith and he or she is known, or reasonably appears, to be a law enforcement officer. 2. A law enforcement officer, or any person whom the officer has summoned or directed to assist him or her, is not justified in the use of force if the arrest or execution of a legal duty is unlawful and known by him or her to be unlawful. Our civil rights and criminal defense lawyers are happy to speak to your group about the do's and don'ts of protesting free of charge. Feel free to give us a call. We invite you to review all of our blogs which govern the right of people to assemble, protest and freely express themselves. The Ten Commandments of Lawful Protesting. Trespassing in Jacksonville, Florida. What are the rules?
Cop on. Policing the police every single day.
Oh, Gary Snow is here.
How you doing, James?
All right, you're on notice. I am already talking to a lawyer about filing stalking charges against
you.
You have threatened me.
Where?
I've already been told you have threatened my.
You've been told the hearsay?
Yeah, you have.
Well,
you have defamed me.
Too.
And I've already contacted a lawyer, dude.
Can you call me a fascist, racist?
It's because you are, dude.
Contact a lawyer. I'm exercising my right to free speech.
Oh, okay. That's correct. I know. Because I'm exercising my Second Amendment.
So he thinks I threaten him. I'm exercising my First Amendment right out here. We're at a public event. This is a Second Amendment event. I support the right to be out here.
So, do you know who this is?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, yeah. Correct.
Andrew Shitbag has a BB gun. Are you allowed to carry?
Yes, I am, and I have put you on notice. You have made threats of bodily harm. You have defamed us illegally.
What threat?
You have made videos that you've defamed us.
Yes,
you went around and have defamed us. You have you've told people that you want to do bodily harm. I've contacted Laura in Jacksonville.
You defamed me. You defamed the Charlotte County Sheriff's Office.
No, I don't think so, buddy.
You defamed the Jobbers Miller family when you showed up during his funeral.
Really?
You defamed Officer Gentry's family.
Really? So he
made a video saying that freedom was planted when an officer gets assassinated in the line
correct.
Of duty.
You think so
it's okay
everything
that cops
he
get shot
did.
And killed.
Go
you
ahead.
Advocate
that's fine.
For cops to get shot and killed. Do you think?
I do not.
But
that is where
good.
You're lying and defaming, bud.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
So you say freedom is.
Rewatch the videos, buddy. What our founding fathers consider.
You don't know anything.
Oh, I do. I do.
You think everybody's racist? You think
Brian, you are?
Black, you think your black neighbor's a racist?
Ah, he is.
He's white because he mows his yard. Hey. What's up, Solo Yager?
Hey.
Because
hey,
he mows his yard.
How are you, man?
45 all day.
To some people.
No. I
got you.
Right. Between me and you,
yeah.
I got mad respect because you do what you do.
Right.
Let's keep it civil.
We are.
Correct.
Okay, perfect. That's all I can ask.
That's it.
That's all I can
exactly.
Say. I'm just expressing my heresy conspiracy theories.
You're doing everything that you should be doing,
right?
As a First Amendment auditor.
This is the first one to admit it, but these guys say I'm stalking or harassing.
I got mad respect.
This is an open event, right? Open event.
It's free to the public.
Free to the public.
Everybody.
This is public. What do the First Amendment auditors say? Perfect. When you're in public, you have no rights.
Exactly.
It's the privacy, right?
Exactly.
All right.
I give
you
a lot of respect, man.
Right on.
My respect.
Right on. What are you running for, state rep?
Yes, sir.
Which district?
District 84.
84.
Yeah. I'm trying to make it.
West Palm?
No, it's just north of that. And
you know,
I'm
by the way, did you bring anything?
I have Maverick.
You know, Enrique is
running. Oh, very, very
that's
good.
That's the first time I had it. It looks like a left hand.
Wow. Why, what do you got? Why, what did you bring?
But I give you Maverick respect. Thank you for being out here.
No worries.
Very, very good.
Thank you for exercising.
I can't even. I just keep it in short.
Right.
I really carried it.
Exactly.
Like I say, it has a... Well, left hand holster.
Right.
I didn't even realize that until I tried to put it on a while ago.
As long as it works, man.
Yeah, it works.
No problem. Mike Taylor.
Nice to meet you finally.
Yes, sir.
Wait, he said Hitler. He's a Nazi.
Sweet. He's a Nazi.
Wait, he said he's a Nazi.
How you doing?
I'm German. I'm German. I'm Hitler.
My granddad was a Nazi. My granddad was a Nazi.
Negative? Did you ever see the documents that we found?
Go Patriots.
Did you ever find the documents that we found out the Charlotte County Sheriff has an illegal list of gun owners?
Oh, I don't doubt that.
He's running for sheriff. Are you running for sheriff, Andrew?
Yeah.
What county?
So Charlotte County Sheriff Bill Permel, so he supports the police and the sheriff that violate the law.
I support the good cops. I already talked to this gentleman, Andrew.
I know.
Okay, you already know. Okay, so anyway.
I'm from Highlands County.
Oh, all right. Then you already know.
You know, in Highlands, we lost an officer called William Gentry.
Yes, sir.
He posted a video saying that freedom was planted. He posted the video of them doing a ceremony in front of Highlands County Sheriff's Office.
That's right.
And he posted a video saying that freedom was planted when Officer Gentry was shot and killed.
And he said, you know why?
Right.
He was shot in the head because that's the only way you can get him,
because
they wear body armor.
Anybody
and
anymore.
He said, now Officer Gentry cannot cause any problems to the citizens of Highlands County.
That's true.
Yeah, so he glorifies the death of police officers.
So he started all this insanity when there was a cop up in Chicago that killed a black man illegally, shot 16 times, and this fucking psycho said that he thinks that. That's awesome.
Was he convicted?
All right.
Was he convicted?
Yes, he was.
So he's
and
in
you
jail,
still
right?
support him.
I don't.
You want to see the gun list?
I don't want to hear any bad mouthing.
Okay.
Any other member.
All right. Do you want to see the gun list? He's not a member, by the way.
Of what? What are you a member of? This guy. This guy's a press. He took a photo, and he laminated it, put it around his neck on a lanyard.
So this is the gun
list. Now he's a freelance journalist.
I'm good.
Okay. Good.
He's good.
Very good.
Quit harassing people.
Correct. You're harassing people, and that's why we're filing charges against you, dipshit.
We don't want to hear about your scandals and your conspiracy.
So are you for the first time?
I'm from Germany. I told you I'm the Nazi from Germany.
Oh, you're
right.
So this is going to be the second or third warning. Like I said, I've contacted the lawyer in Jacksonville who already had to deal with you. Okay, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that guy can kiss my ass.
Okay, that's great. You've been warned a second and third time.
Yeah.
We are going to file, so you've been warned.
I've been warned. Thank you, sir.
Correct.
Thank you for your warning.
Yes.
Thank you for warning about my First Amendment right to film in public. Right?
So, yes, he's a bad... He's a Nazi.
I'm a Nazi.
It's great. That's
did you,
good.
Did
that's
you a, know Did you know he supports cops illegally killing black people? That's
no,
how
I
he,
support,
that's
I support
how he started
having,
his group.
I support cops. I think they deserve
that's
their
how
day in court.
Supported this
instead
group.
Of a street court where people want to hold trial in the streets and already convict a cop before he has a trial. So Jason Van Dyke did go to trial. He was convicted and he's in jail.
And he still supports
no, I don't. What did I say? What have I said since? I've also threatened
him. He did threaten me. I've already been told.
So hearsay?
Already told somebody.
Is that hearsay?
Already been told.
And
so
they want to impeach Trump on hearsay too.
That's what's messed up. He's for Trump. Trump wants to drain the swamp, but he doesn't want to drain the swamp.
Are you pro
down
Trump?
Here of corruption.
Because he's a Republican.
Yeah.
Are you a Republican or
go
like
ahead,
independent?
Ask him.
Are
ask
you a Republican
him.
Or an independent?
Ask him. Go
you
ahead.
You know, Trump is like the most pro-police president that we've ever had.
To a bad point.
So do you support a president?
Every president has a good and a bad side.
That's right.
What I want to tell you, I arrived here first time in my life 20 years ago here. I bought a house, and where I lived close to here was a section. Was the Ku Klux Klan? There was no Mexican. There was no
he would like to join that. Please tell him where
it's
at.
What's funny, Andrew Sheets doesn't know is that there's a guy called Richard Spencer who's a known neo-Nazi. He went to Gainesville. There's video of me out there protesting Richard Spencer, who's a known Nazi. So I was out there protesting. Also in Jacksonville, there's a video, and I'll post it. I'll post this just
he
for Andrew.
Started a riot.
All these people were out there protesting.
He was
Trump
arrested
after,
for starting
and,
a riot.
Neo-Nazi showed up full garb, the whole swastika, and the only one that got in this guy's face and told him to get the fuck out of here was me.
And
the news
and
reported they said nobody really appreciated a Nazi.
We can do without the foul language.
What's
man.
That?
We can do without your foul mouth.
Okay. Well,
there's a lot of children around.
Okay.
Here.
Okay. All right.
Cool
Thank
it
you.
With the cussing.
All right. Fuck off.
Yeah.
You, really?
Yeah. To both of you
yeah,
guys talk about
that.
What the problem is.
What's that?
You are the problem, and you are the problem because you're out here making fools out of the Conservative Party.
You know about the Ku Klux Klan here in Naples? Naples was a very clean city.
Right.
It was so clean, the city, and now, after years, if you come over Saturday and Sunday, just Mexican people on the beach here. Never seen before.
Are you serious?
Wow. No Mexican people. There wasn't that here 10 years and 50 years before. Nothing.
Correct.
No black people, nothing. And now?
Correct.
That's the problem here, you know, the influence and the...
So what I do is I bust the corrupt cops and expose it on Facebook and YouTube. And this is my stalker and racist fascist right here.
He thinks you know white people are racist. He thinks brown people are racist. He thinks black people are racist. Because you think your neighbors are racist, right?
Yeah.
So real quick, if you think black people are racist, do you think that there's such a thing as black supremacy?
Dude, I told you.
Do you think there's such a thing called black supremacy?
Dude, you're a racist. You supported a white cop killing a
black
man.
Do you think there's such a thing?
Executed him. It's crazy, man.
Do you think there's such a thing as black supremacy?
It's, dude. Trump would be ashamed of you, man. Okay, I've already told you for the fourth, the fifth time now on video. I've contacted a lawyer. Leave me alone. You have stalked me. You have threatened me. Sorry, dude. You already did it online. You documented it. You went to different places defaming me, you moron.
How did I defame you?
You did.
What'd I say?
You did. You did.
You're not
going to
get anywhere arguing.
Oh, I know. I'm not arguing. I'm auditing the auditor.
I am like completely.
Yeah. This is totally separate from the Second Amendment.
I can say
this is my First Amendment.
I got it.
I'm recording.
The only way we're ever going
to. I'm attorney represented. I have one on retainer, so I don't really want to talk to you after listening to a few of the remarks you just made. So you can mosey on. Talk to someone else.
What did I make?
Oh damn, Andrew.
Yeah, I know. I see that.
Mm-hmm. He said, "Why don't you just mosey on?"
There you go. Yep,
see,
that's fine, man.
Not everybody cares about your crap.
Yep. So, I would like to say cease and desist. You have been. Okay. I will get it in somewhere else. All right. Yes. Dude, you rock. You are awesome, man. Thank you for all the help.
No problem.
You are excellent. He thinks I hate all cops. I do not hate all cops.
Hold on, wait,
I
gotta flip this around. I swear to God.
Oh, come on, man.
I'm not a good camera guy like you. He's got the whole stick.
You got it?
Okay, ready?
Here we go. Here, say I love cops.
I love good cops.
All right, we hold
That's
the bad
fair,
ones accountable.
Right?
Yeah,
I hold the bad ones accountable. Is that fair?
There you go.
Dude, you rock, man. You're awesome.
But,
thank you for the help.
Yeah, no problem. Anytime. Yeah, good luck with that.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, do you know what came out of that case? Eric Friday found out, did you guys hear about this, that they were going over 3 days on getting people guns? You know, they're supposed to have 3 days to decide, can you have a gun or not?
Right.
Eric found out, like the same guy was over 60 days. He started a class action lawsuit on that. So he's waiting to see how that goes. Then he'll go for the biggest class action gun lawsuit in Florida's history on this pawn list. Is that sad?
That is sad.
That is sad.
That is sad.
So, anyways, you totally passed, man. You rock.
All right. Take care of yourself.
Are you the unicorn I've been looking for?
No.
Hey, can I ask a real question, Adam? Andy.
Did I give you a card yet?
If this officer gets killed in line of duty, do you think freedom is planted?
Thank you.
Do you think freedom is planted if that officer was killed in the line of duty?
I don't know.
So did you hear? It's just like I thought. The cops are here because of this guy. Yes.
Why are they here because of me?
Because he's un-American. He's swearing, violating our rights. It's sad, man.
What rights did I violate?
Correct.
Stalking.
Don't let him talk to you.
I'm a freelance journalist. I'm with the press.
Oh, okay.
I don't have my credentials yet.
Exactly.
See, because I didn't take a picture and I didn't laminate it and I didn't stick it around lanyard.
That's because you have no idea about our history, man. None.
Everybody's freelance journalists, right? Anybody can be a freelance journalist. I'm a freelance
journalist.
Why
are you harassing
people? I'm doing a story
on
Andrew Sheets, who's running for Charlotte County Sheriff.
Correct.
So I'm doing a story on Andrew Sheets. We're in public. This is a public.
You've already been warned multiple times. I'm contacting a lawyer because you're stalking.
I'll call Phillips tomorrow. I wish you would.
Correct.
He took down the report, GarySnow.com. That's how vindictive that guy was. So you could have filed a report.
Exactly. Correct.
I think I'm done with Andrew Sheets today.
Google his name. All right. So anyways, I cease and desist again. I'd rather not talk to you. You've already filed false charges, so I'd rather not talk to you. Yeah, you did.
Keep your lies.
Yeah, you
to
did.
Yourself.
No, it's true, dude. I got the documents.
Send me.
Go for great.
If I did something illegal to you, send me.
Okay, I'm letting you know I do not want to talk to you because
it's
all right,
place,
there
man.
You go, man.
Public
and now
place.
You're harassing me, so I'd appreciate it if you quit harassing me.
Nobody's harassing you.
So anyways,
hey Sheriff County, this is Sheriff County Cop Watch. I am using any video here with under fair use. If you have criticism, reporting, teaching, etc., and please donate. I do not make money from YouTube, and there are different ways to donate in the video links. Thanks.